As we've been discussing on the show this morning, Waka Kotahi, the transport agency, is starting what they describe as a trial of safety cameras in three different Auckland locations in order to get an insight into how many people drive while using their mobile phones, as well as the numbers who don't wear their seat belts. And zooming in, appropriately enough, from the Hawke's Bay with his view on the value of this initiative, we're delighted to welcome motorsport legend and road safety advocate Greg Murphy. Morning, Greg. How are you? Long time no see.
Morena, yeah, thank you, Jenny May. Great to see you and thanks for having me on this morning.
So are you deliberately in your car for this interview or are you heading somewhere?
I'm about to go to the gym. So I'm just fitting this in before I hit the gym this morning. So yes,
you're a good man.
Car, but as you can see, I'm not moving. I'm parked.
No, brilliant. Hey, Greg, thank you for your time this morning. So what do you think of this latest initiative by Waka Kotahi? It's going to go over 6 months. No fines issued. It's about gathering information and all photos will disappear after 48 hours. Where do you sit on this?
Well, I think the idea and the technology is a great idea. I think, and I remember it actually being talked about some years ago, this kind of technology, taking images of people using their phones while driving, seatbelts, that kind of thing. It's taken a very long time for it to get to this stage. The trial, you got to test get the data and bits and pieces, but if you just go stand on any street corner anywhere in New Zealand, particularly around Auckland, probably this time of the morning as well, but at any moment you will see multiple people using their phones while driving within a very short period of time. Just talk to the police about it. The police have all the information, the data. I mean, they've been there. They've been seeing it for years now. So I'm not really sure why we need to go through this process to gather a whole lot more data that we already know exists and to get something that tells us something we already know. It seems a little bit ridiculous in that respect, and then also to not utilise any of it, not send out warning notices to anyone that is doing it to start the process. I just sort of think it's a bit of a unnecessary, sort of useless announcement that they should have been doing the trial, shouldn't have told us about it. We don't need to know. Just get it cracking and getting it underway.
Yeah, it's interesting because a lot of what you're saying is the feedback that we are hearing from our viewers as well in terms of why isn't the data that's collected over that 6 months, why aren't notices being issued? This is already an issue that we know about. We've all seen it and someone else actually did point that out too. You go and stand on any street, central Auckland, and you will see a multitude of people using their cell phones. So what should we be doing then if we are looking at how we can curb? Because my understanding is that this information will tell us about our habits, our driving habits. Yep. So what should we be doing in order to try and get us to change our driving habits, to leave our phones in the glove box or in our bags and put our bloody seatbelts on?
Yep. I mean, the seatbelt thing is just... it's mind-blowing, and I still struggle when I talk to police that they are still seeing so many people without their seatbelts, obviously, and lots of incidents as well, crashes, accidents that happen, people not wearing their seatbelts, which, again, is just adding to the statistics in a big way unnecessarily. We've just got very poor habits because we've really just had no real incentive to change. I mean, this whole mobile phone situation, we've been so slow to get on the bandwagon of trying to get people to change their habits through, unfortunately, having to provide penalties along the way. I mean, it was only $80 or something or less up until last year sometime
initially,
when the fine got changed. But $120 or $150, people are just not. They just don't care. That's not an incentive to stop using your phone while driving.
Okay, so Greg, should we be educating people as opposed to enforcement, or where's the solution?
Well, education. I mean, that's an interesting one. I mean, really, if you've got, I'm sorry, but if you've got, you know, any sort of common sense, you know that it's not right, and everyone knows that it's not right to use their phone. So education is not really an issue there. We know distraction is a contributing factor to crashes and statistics much, much more. Even Waka Kotahi will admit that the reports on statistics are under underdone. So we know that there is a much more, much more issues around distraction than what's being reported. Mm. Everyone knows that you shouldn't use your phone. Everyone knows when you're driving.
It was actually dumb of me to say education, right? Because actually we do.
So that's not working. You know, Waka Kotahi is saying that they want people to be supported in making better decisions. Well, what does that exactly mean? I mean, that's again, that's just a real PC, sort of low-level, soft kind of approach. You know, the ads that they're using at the moment are really just not doing the job. They're costing us a fortune, and we're not achieving anything. It's you know, the statistics around what they are achieving through their planning, the KPIs are not being met in any way, shape, or form. Unfortunately, we've got to harden up. We really do have to harden up, and people need to be deterred from making these poor decisions. And the way we're going about at the moment, that is not happening.
Loving your work, Greg. I don't want to keep you from the gym, so I'll let you go. But just
Please quickly,
can I ask you about Bathurst? Are you going? Are you going this year?
That's why I'm going to the gym.
Go, you good thing. We're going to see you back at Bathurst. I love it.
I know. I don't know what. I don't know. I've been brainwashed or something. I'm not sure. I don't think it's a great idea.
I think it's a great idea. A lot of motorsport fans will think it's a great idea. Actually, we must catch up before then. Greg, thanks so much for your time. Really appreciate it. Take care, mate.
Thanks, team. Thank you.